Hi Pisces, and welcome to your weekly tarot reading for the week of November. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you're doing really, really well. This reading is for any sun, moon, or rising Pisces. We will take a look at the cards. We'll get a sense of the awareness for the week, guidance, and possible outcomes. I will also choose a couple of oracle cards for additional information. So let's just get started with your reading. So in your current position, you have the Magician. And in this illustration, you can see that the Magician is standing behind a table, arm raised in the air with his wand, the infinity symbol above his head. On the table are all of the elements, sword, cups, pentacles. He's holding the wand. And so when we see the Magician in a reading, this is that you are wanting to manifest, you're wanting to create, you're wanting to build your life, and you have developed skills, you have mastery, and now you're ready to do something with that. You're thinking about it and you're hoping to create, you're hoping to manifest. And really this card is telling you to have faith in your abilities. Trust in the universe providing what you need and make a plan. You know, dreaming about it and hoping for it isn't going to make it into a reality. And the Magician is telling you that you have the ability to create and to manifest the life that you want. You have to make a plan. And what's crossing you is this Knight of Pentacles. And as you see this Knight of Pentacles, he's sitting on the horse and he's observing his pentacle, and that's the horse is in parade rest where he's not moving. And so with this Knight of Pentacles, we have this Pentacles energy, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, grounded, practical, common sense, hardworking and diligent, someone who is studious and dependable, responsible. May not be the most exciting energy in the world, but it's, boots on the ground, working hard, getting things done. And so combining this Magician with the Knight of Pentacles is a positive, because this can give you setting forth a plan, looking at an issue. How are you going to do it? What are the nuts and bolts of creating the life that you want? In your foundation is the Two of Swords, and we can see the woman here sitting in her chair, arms crossed with the two swords, blindfolded. And often, this is a card where we might feel blocked. We may feel that we don't want to deal with a situation. We don't want to face it. We'd kind of hope that it's gonna just stay over there for a bit. And, you know, when you're blocking your heart like this, nothing is going out and really nothing's coming in. And sometimes you're not willing to see the truth of a situation. You're not ready to deal with the truth of a situation. So it's your foundation. Something has been, it's just not been open to looking at it with clarity. And so with twos, it also suggests having to make a decision, having to make a choice between two different scenarios. With this Two of Swords, you know, she can take off those blindfolds and stand up and have some action. She can rip off the blindfold and decide to see the truth. But with this card, there's a sense of your unwillingness or your challenge of having to make decisions, and it just seems that you can't move forward. You're blindfolded. You're just kind of stuck here. In your recent past is the World card. Fabulous card. This card is about fulfillment, contentment, realizing your dreams, and bringing a project to fruition, bringing it to completion, and feeling good about it. And you can see the woman here within the wreath. She's kind of skip dancing. She has this purple sash on, and you know, it's a sense of recognition for your accomplishment. And it's a wholeness, it's a fulfillment of doing a job well done. And so this could very much go to your current position, which is, you know, I've kind of accomplished this stage of my career, or I've had this great relationship. You know, what is going to be next? What am I going to create or manifest next? So I think that you're looking for the next cycle. And again, with the world, just because you've accomplished it doesn't mean you stop. You keep growing. You keep creating a new journey for yourself. This is the end of the major arcana. So from this, we start again. What's crowning you is justice. And so it seems like an issue of fairness is something that's on your mind. A situation about being either treated fairly. Now, whether you're treating someone fairly, whether you're not being treated fairly, this goes to equity. It goes to equality. You can see the scales of justice, and her sword is raised high. Decisions. This could also suggest there's some type of legal matter that you're having to deal with. Maybe it's parking fines. Maybe it's a separation. Maybe it's the dissolution of a business, but there's something here that is relating to contracts, relating to the fine print, relating to the issue of fairness. And so when justice comes up, it's a matter of sometimes karma. Look at your past actions, you know, have you been treating people fairly? Have they been treating you fairly? So it's something that you're thinking about in November. In your near future is the Seven of Wands. And this Wands energy is Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And we get a sense here of this guy. He's kind of standing above these other people with their wands. And he's in a defensive position. This is about having to defend yourself. And you have to defend yourself. Perhaps it's your beliefs. Maybe it's your desire to move in a new direction, of manifesting in a new direction. Maybe you're having to defend yourself when it comes to the truth or decisions. But this is about really protecting yourself, defending yourself. It looks like you have the advantage from your position of where you're standing. You know, you have the position, these people are well below, and you're doing your best to keep them off your back. Excuse me. So, yeah, with justice, and justice is Libra. Okay, so where you are right now, it's more defending yourself and protection. We have the Nine of Wands, and again, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And with this Nine of Wands, this warrior, we see him standing outside of these other tall wands, bandaged, looks a little worse for the wear. And it's the sense of being tired from having to keep at it, to keep protecting. And, you know, he's looking over his shoulder here as if saying, gosh, what's coming next at me? You know, I'm ready, but whew, it's getting to be exhausting. This card, even though you're protecting yourself and defending yourself and having to do so in November, it really does suggest that you have determination and that you're persistent and you have a lot of courage to keep at it. Many people might put the wand down and roll out of there and say, I've had enough. But with this Nine card, you're so close to fruition and to completion that hang in there just a little bit more. And this is, again, this is this sense of having to defend yourself either with family, friends, your partner, your lover, your wife, husband, in terms of beliefs or actions or plans that you want to make. And in your environment, it's some opportunity for some very clear thinking. Aces are gifts, blessings, opportunities from the universe. And you can see the hand holding out the sword, holding the sword. Here is the sword. It's piercing the crown. This is an opportunity or a blessing to you for very clear thinking, clarity within a situation, communication that's clear. So if you need to tell some people some things when it comes to defending yourself, you're going to have this very straightforward and no-nonsense, unemotional way of delivering the message. And maybe having to clear out the BS and to say, yeah, I'm cutting through this nonsense. We're not going down this path. That's really what the Ace of Swords brings: clarity, the sharpness of the blade, the ability to look at an issue from both sides, to be informed about a matter. So if you're defending yourself, you know the facts. You know what's going on. And if you feel that you've been treated unfairly, you know, you're going to be able to clearly articulate that and communicate that to whomever. And to say enough is enough, you know, let's not go there. And again, just to reinforce this sense of clarity that you're going to get. In November, it's the Queen of Swords, and she's very decisive. She's fair, unemotional, rational. So this is rational thinking. Someone who can make the decision, someone who's going to do the due diligence, the hard work underneath of having to get a message across, having to deliver it very clearly. And you know, there's no, when you deliver the message clearly, it's going to make you feel better. You know, transparency, saying exactly what's on your mind. And maybe it comes out blunt. Maybe it comes out as criticism. But you know what? You're defending yourself, and that's okay. You are having to protect your beliefs or your property or whatever it may be. You're in this protective mode, and if you have to be blunt, straightforward, and clear, then so be it. Then do that. You know, don't mince words. When you have the swords here, have a lot of this air intellectual energy, don't hesitate to speak the truth. It's about, swords are about the truth. And in your outcome, we have the beautiful Star card. And the Star card, we see this woman here without her clothes on, pouring water in the pond, pouring water on Earth as well, guided by the stars. And there's a sense here of connection and balance between the physical and spiritual senses that you have, and that this is a time of healing. And this episode here, where you may be speaking your mind, you may be telling it like it is in terms of defending yourself about what you want to create or manifest or decisions that you have to make, that it may require some healing on your part, meditation, some rest, healthy eating. This is we look to the stars for inspiration. And with the Star card, we have hope and optimism that everything's going to work out. That within your plans and your hopes and at your very core of where you are, you're hoping to manifest something new. You're hoping to create and to build an extension to your life that is positive and hopeful. And if, whether that's through a relationship, a career change, finding your passion and trying to make a living from your passion, you've had success, you're feeling whole, you do have a little uncertainty and a little blind spot perhaps that you're having to navigate. Something has come up with respect to fairness or contracts that you need to pay attention to. Whether you're being fair or unfair, there's here a sense of defense and clear speaking. And that can be exhausting. And so with the Star card, A, it's telling you that everything is going to work out for you. B, it's saying take some time to heal. Take some time to recover, to restore, and to re-energize yourself. Now, what's interesting with this reading, we have swords, we have one pentacle, we have some major arcana, and wands. We don't have cups in this reading. So this is a month where perhaps the emotional side of you is not at the forefront. You're dealing with a lot of nitty-gritty, perhaps issues with people, with plans, with projects ending, new projects beginning, making decisions, and recovering. So even though we don't see cups here in the reading, let's go ahead and get a sense of what what we can find out for love. I believe this is called the Power of Love Oracle. Integrity. You demonstrate the truth and honesty of your soul and manifest love with your every action. So having integrity, integrity goes toward the Queen of Swords, truthfulness, fairness, decisiveness, maybe a little blunt, maybe a little critical, maybe a little cold and unemotional, but is delivering a fair message. Intellectual approaches here and opportunities, again, to bring in new enterprise, new way of thinking, clear communication, clear truth, bringing out the truth. Truth, and here's the truth within this card, the honesty of your soul, and then manifest love with your every action. Having the magician at your very core, maybe it's with respect to manifesting a relationship. Maybe it's with respect to manifesting a new career path, passive income, whatever it may be. You're thinking of building something, and Pentacles is going to give you the nuts and bolts to get it done. And again, integrity, the Knight of Pentacles, trustworthy, loyal, honest, hardworking, and integrity with the Justice card. Doing what's fair, doing what's right, dealing with unjust situations. And finally, to close the reading, let's pull a practice area or a theme for the month. Cycles and rhythms. Honor the cycles of your body, energy levels, and emotions. It goes nicely with the Star card, which is really taking care of your mind, body, spirit, paying attention to you, being open, being vulnerable, allowing your own light to shine, your own truth to come out, allowing people to enjoy you for who you are. And so the cycles, the world is pretty much a cycle card. One cycle ends, we're going to start a new one here. Again, the magician, starting something new. The potential with the Ace of Swords. So, listen to your body, listen to your mind of what's going on within your situation. And, you are holding some of the nicest cards, the Star, the Magician, the World, Justice, the Ace of Swords, in creating some movement within your life for November. I hope that you found something here that resonated with you. If you did, please like, share, or comment on this video. And if you haven't subscribed, then please subscribe. It's a great way to show support and to stay connected. And I hope that I will see you again next month. Many blessings to you in November. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.